Alright, welcome in this morning. This is Girls Division 3. I guess there is no boys volleyball, so it's kind of a given that it's Girls Division 3, but an ace served up to get this going. As Jordan Pace from Haywood Christian gets things going in this Girls Division 3. I call it second chance bracket. It's the loser's bracket, but you still have an opportunity to win the championship, so.
Shelby Hughes coming in for Georgia Cumberland. Right away here.
So Georgia Cumberland in those blue uniforms serving left to right out of Calhoun, Georgia. Haywood Christian Academy in those red uniforms out of Clyde, North Carolina. And finally, a different type of mascot this morning. We have the Jaguars on one side and the Red Wolves on the other side.
Wow.
So a 2-1 lead for Cumberland. Red Wolves. I like that. That's different. Somewhat unique.
I don't know that I've ever heard that before.
No.
That's a good logo. Good mascot.
So, Surf here, now played up front. Tipped across there by Jessica Circa. Now Cumberland plays it. Good dig in that back row by Hayes Stanbury. That's the libero for the Red Wolves this morning. And sent across by Allen Moll. Now Cumberland to play it. That's Jordan Jablonski in the front row putting it across for Cumberland. Now sent back over by Circa. Try middle this time. And there's a kill for Allie Moll. And we are tied at 2 here in game 1.
Coming in for Haywood Academy, Kerry Green.
Serve for Jessica Circa is an ace and a 3-2 lead for the Red Wolves.
What do you know about Klein, North Carolina, John? Anything?
I honestly could say I've never even heard of Clyde, North Carolina. Some of these places I've heard of and haven't been to, I've never even heard of Clyde, North Carolina. That's served out of bounds. The service error makes it a 3 all tie. Why, do you have some sort of words of wisdom about
no.
Clyde?
Don't know any Woody Lees in Clyde, that's for sure. We've analyzed every other town, though.
Yeah, we have. Time for a Wikipedia search.
That's right.
Serve here by Jablonski. Is deflected back into the net by Cassie Jones. And a 4-3 lead for Cumberland. And once again, Jordan Jablonski to serve. Up front, Jones. Off to Kerry Green, who puts it across. And now Hughes to play it for Cumberland. Back up front, dumped over there by Green. They're going to try Hughes again on the far side, and that will count as a kill for Shelby Hughes and a 5-3 lead for Cumberland.
A lot of volleyball to be played here at NACA Championship Day today. All the way, last game scheduled for 8:30 tonight.
And I can almost, I'm not going to say this for sure, but that a service error will make it 5-4. Cumberland is into the, well, there you go. I almost did your job again. As I get ready to serve for the Red Wolves is Hattie Stanbury.
I believe that was Shelby Llewellyn you were about to mention coming in.
Mm-hmm. Serve here. Played up front by Danzik, and then fired across by Moore. And that hit out of bounds, and will make it a 6-4 lead for Cumberland. What I was going to say was, I can almost guarantee you 100% that that game isn't going to start at 8:30.
Yeah, I'm sure you're right.
Now, if everything goes completely according to plan, that's possible, but not very likely. There's an ace served up in a 7-4 lead now.
If everything goes as scheduled today, I would imagine the Lord will return before the end of the night.
that's very, very possible. They could be real late tonight before this thing is over. Dumped across by Jones. Now set to the outside. Put over there by Mei Chin. And tipped over by Jones again. Cassie will set it middle this time for Allie Moore, and that's a kill and a 7-5 lead for Cumberland.
A lot of power on that ball going in that kill. Red Wolves coach, is in her second season here with Haywood.
Put across by Jess Rosales for Cumberland. Tap back over by Jones. Danzig to the near side and sent across there by Hughes. Now Cumberland with it again. Moore dumps it back across. Jones in the middle. Set over by Pace. Bump back across. Now put over by Green. Danzig to the outside to Chin. That is a kill in that back corner. So an 8-5 lead for Cumberland.
I believe you'd have to be standing on the line almost to return that volley there.
And there's an ace. Nice serve there from Shelby Hughes. And a 9-5 lead for Cumberland. This one returned on one hit. And sent back across. Red Wolves trying to play it. Tracking it down is Maul. And that will fall in. A 10-5 lead for Cumberland.
Coach Amy Maul there for the Red Wolves told me this is her ninth trip to the NACA. Two with this team and seven with a different team.
Nine times, huh? And sent across by Danzig. Now up front and a kill for Jordan Pace, the 5'9 senior.
Haley Peterson coming in for Cumberland. And also for the Red Wolves, we've got Jessica Circa coming in.
10-6 the lead for Cumberland. And the serve here is out of bounds from Kerry Green, making it 11-6 Cumberland.
And Hayes Stanberry coming in for Haywood Academy. And also for Cumberland, Jordan Jablonski.
Serve here, played back by Circa, and an ace makes it 12-6. So a little bit of a lead here for the Jaguars. And a serve from Sadie Dixon. Played back up front. Dumped over by Jordan Pace. And sent across by Brooklyn Moore. Now up front, that hit into the net by Jordan Pace. And it's 13-6 Cumberland.
Let me encourage you to contact friends and family and let them know to tune in to NACASports.org.
And there's an ace from Sadie Dixon and a 14-6 lead and a timeout to the Red Wolves here from Haywood. We'll take a break. Come back with more in just a moment. Surf here now, played up front, sent across there by Jordan Pace. Little block there by Pace at the net, and then sent back across. This returned out of bounds by Sadie Dixon. And a 14-7 lead for Cumberland. Back to serve for the Red Wolves is Cassie Jones. Her serve played by Moore. Now put across by Jordan Jablonski. Dancic to the outside. Jablonski again. Dug out by Serka. Dancic now to the other side. And a kill for Jess Rosales. It's 15-7 Cumberland. Well, if I have this right, Clyde, North Carolina is in the far western edge of North Carolina, a town of about 1,200 people.
Wow, big town.
Yeah. That's an ace making it 16. Or did they say we had an error there, so a 15-8 lead now for Cumberland. So back corner by Moore, put back up near the net, that's returned into the net, so an ace makes it 15-9.
Haywood Christian plays in the Blue Ridge Christian Conference. They came in second this year in that conference.
Serve here, now played to the outside, bumped over there by Brooklyn Moore. Played up front for Moll, who put it across, and now this tapped into the net. So 16-9 Cumberland. The 2 points of interest listed for Clyde, North Carolina. The Haywood Community College Arboretum, which I'm guessing means there's Haywood Community College somewhere in the Clyde area. And a September 11th memorial.
Wow.
Which they have a picture of right here somewhere in town. So served there from Jess Rosales. Tipped across out front and an illegal hit on Cassie Jones. That'll make it 17-9.
An arboretum. I'm assuming that deals with trees.
Yes. Yep, the arboretum is usually plants, trees, that kind of thing. Typically, I know the one in Chicago is a gigantic enclosed place. That tipped across by Moore, and now an 18-9 lead. Here now, played by Serka up front, put across by Moll. This tipped and blocked.
Block.
Allie Moll with that block, and it's 18-10. And we have an ace served up, making it 18-12. Now serving again is Jessica Serka. Sadie Dixon plays that off the ceiling. Now up front, bumped across by Dancic. In front it goes, tipped over there by Moll. On the outside, sent across by Hughes. Good dig by Dixon in the back row. Dancic now set over there by Moore. Set deep and a nice play by Dancic, and it's 19-11.
That was a good save by Moll there. Coming into the game for the Red Wolves at number 20. And I don't have 20 on my roster. So that's going to be...
You're talking about the libero?
Hayes Stanberry.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a tricky thing with the libero. They a lot of times have different numbers depending on which uniform they're using. So 19-12 the lead for Cumberland. The serve here for Katie Stanberry of the Red Wolves. And sent across by Shelby Llewellyn. And Dancic will bump it back across. Side put over by Kerry Green for the kill. And it's 19-13. I was looking at Haywood Community College. 2,700 students.
Wow.
That's a really decent sized school. 83 acres on their campus. That's a fairly large campus.
Yes, it is.
Bumped across by Dancic. And a little the floor put over there by Allie Moll. That hit out of bounds. by Hughes, and it'll make it 19-14.
That would be 20-something acres larger than the campus here at NACA.
And this is a big, pretty big place. Serve now. Tracked down on the far side by Chin. Dumped over by Dancic. Now Stanberry puts it over. Dancic up front. Tipped over there by Moore. Now Timberland will play it again. Tipped over and in. It's 20-14, the lead for Cumberland. By the way, their campus includes an arboretum, which we already mentioned, a mill pond, and a working grist mill, which was constructed by the students at the college.
Wow.
Interesting. I've been to a lot of junior colleges. I don't remember one with a grist mill.
No, that's got to be a first.
It's tipped over. Now Cumberland will play it. That's Hughes putting it back across. Opportunity here for the Red Wolves. Dumped over there by Cassie Jones. Outside Chin. Now Haywood with it. Put across there by Green. Jones. It's in the middle. And across by Allie Mull. Now Chin with the kill, and it's 21-14.
You know, let me make a correction here. That wouldn't be 20 acres larger. It'd be about 15 acres larger than NACA. But still, that's a big
yeah,
campus.
That's large. That's served out of bounds by Brooklyn Moore. It's 21-15. Serve returned on one hit. Jones. Back to the middle, put across there by Pace. This deflects around. Cassie Jones comes up with it, though. Back near side, sent across by Green. Middle of the floor, little battle at the net. Eventually won by Haywood. It's 21-16, Cumberland. Dumped over by Shelby Hughes. Play back across. Cumberland will try to work with it here. Dancic. Now Haywood's Peggy Stanberry with a kill there. It's 21-17. And the Red Wolves slowly working their way back into this game, trail by just four now. Wow, that's a nice serve from Allie Mull. Bumped over there by Green. Now set across by Moore. Playing that is Stanberry. Come back over. Middle of the floor, it goes for Pace. The Red Wolves will try to put it back across again. This into the net. Saved by Rosales, but out of bounds. It's 21-18. And a timeout to Georgia Cumberland. Take a break. Back with more of the first in just a minute. All right, 21-18, the lead for Cumberland. Serve here by Moll. Now played up front, and another kill this time by Jordan Pace, and it's 21-19. Well, the Red Wolves making a charge here late. Served by Moll. And up the cross by Chin. Jones back to the near side. Across there. Danzig over to Hughes. Tracked down by Stanberry. Bump back across. And over by Hughes. This is Hattie Stanberry with that hit. Now across to Chin. Bumped over there by Green. Now Hughes again, and that will eventually fall in. That's a big point for Cumberland as they lead it 22-19. So now to serve for Georgia Cumberland is Shelby Hughes. Serve played up front. That hit, that would have been out of bounds, but played by Shelby Llewellyn, and so it's 22-20.
Coming in for the Red Wolves, number 5, Jessica Circa.
Serve here, played now up to Danzig. Out it goes, tipped across by Rosales. Back over for Jessica Circa. She'll hit it out of bounds. It's 23-20, Cumberland.
Number 10, Haley Peterson coming in for Cumberland. Also, number 20, Hay Stanberry for Haywood. Number 4, Jordan Jablonski coming in for Cumberland.
A serve coming up here from CeeDee Dixon. Played by Jones. Sent across by Jordan Pace. Outside, tipped over there by Cassie Jones. Now Cassie back to the middle. That's Pace again. And this set over by Moore. Outside to Jablonski. And that hit out of bounds by Jessica Circa, and it's 24-20, now a game point for Cumberland. Serve here from Dixon. Tracked down by Allie Moll, now put across. He's bumped over deep, played there by Stanberry. And that played off the ceiling. And that will end game one. 25-20, the win for Cumberland. Take a break. We'll be back with game two in a minute. You're watching the NACA.
All right, it's the second match, our second game here in this match with Cumberland Christian and Haywood, Cumberland Academy and Haywood Christian. Haywood with a set hit for a kill. That'd be number five. Circa with that kill on that point. Pace about to serve for Haywood Christian. Bump. And that would be an ace for Haywood Christian.
An ace and a nice block from Allie Moll, too. I guess technically, if she touched it, it might not be an ace, but it could have gone into the net, too. That was a close one.
Serve for Haywood goes out of bounds. Cumberland Christian, number 9, Rosales to serve.
I was checking the lineup for Cumberland. Comes Shelby Hughes. She'll replace Haley Peterson.
Rosales thinks about it.
It's one of those weird things about volleyball is they'll let you. You would think they wouldn't let you restart, but they do.
Set by Haywood. Hit, and it's in bounds.
It's a nice play by Allie Moll with the kill back in for the Red Wolves. And returns Carrie Green, a senior.
Circa about to serve for Haywood Christian. Bump by Rosales. Set. That would be a point for Haywood Christian.
Yeah, Rosales had a little bit of difficulty trying to use the set motion off of that hit in the back row.
Circa to serve. And out of bounds on that serve.
Whew. That was just, that barely got out of bounds. The libero, he's Stanberry back in for the Red Wolves. And back in for Georgia Cumberland is Mei Chin.
Jordan Jablonski about to serve for Georgia Cumberland. Set by Haywood. And we have,
I think Brooklyn Moore is in the net for Cumberland, so that'll give the point to the Red Wolves.
And Haiti Stanberry about to serve for Haywood Christian.
Shelby Llewellyn also checking back in for Cumberland.
Stanberry with a hit into the net. I'm sorry. Guess Stanberry with a hit into the net. Now Moore serving for Georgia Cumberland.
Well, unfortunately, Moore seems like just when Cumberland gets started, ends up rotating in that back row almost immediately.
And
nice play by Mei Chin with the kill there, and it's a 6-4 lead as the serve here from Brooklyn Morrison up front. Chin trying to just dump it back across. That wouldn't quite work out. Now Chin fires in that back row. Good dig there by Jordan Pace. Sent back across by Green. That's out in, I guess.
Originally it looked out, but it was in.
This way the near side went out. In. Serve here from Allie Moll. Hit the top of the net, but still playable. It didn't used to be that way in High School Volleyball, but they changed that a little while back. Now this is Hattie Stanberry hitting it into the net. And it's a 7-5 Haywood lead. So Shelby Hughes to serve for Cumberland. And that's dug out of that net. Boy, that's a nice play. Hit long and a point for Haywood. That's a real nice play from Kerry Green after it was hitting the net by Pace.
And in for Georgia Cumberland, Haley Peterson and Katie Lassiter.
8-5 the lead for the Red Wolves as Kerry Green will serve. Serve here by Green. Dancic now put across by Chin. Tipped over there by Jones. Sent back by Dancic. Up front. Bumped over and down it goes. So 9-5 the lead for Haywood.
You know, gotta admire you, John. Play by play is a lot harder than it looks.
You know, volleyball is a tricky, it's a tricky one. Some of the stuff is a little bit easier. Volleyball tends to, especially at the higher level, this got knocked out of bounds by Rosales, going to make it 11-5, I believe, for the Red Wolves. But especially when you get to like the Division I games, where it's so fast one side to the other, it becomes much more difficult. But yeah, volleyball is kind of a weird one to do, too. Not a lot of people have done much of it. Or frankly, have watched much of it on TV-wise. So that's a different one. Chin will put it across on the far side, and now the Red Wolves will play it. Cassie Jones sends it over. This, nope, did not touch the ceiling. Came real close, though, from Dancic. And also track it down, bump it across. Sent over there by Pace for Haywood. This is Chin. Played in the back row by Stanberry. Now bumped over there by Pace. Cumberland in the middle. Morales had to track that down. Now hitting to the net by Allie Moll. So 10-6 the lead for Haywood.
Stanberry in for Haywood and Dixon in for Georgia Cumberland, as well as Jablonski in for Georgia Cumberland.
I'll tell you, one of the more difficult sports I've done, though, is hockey. I did that for a while, and it's fun, but that's a whole other world trying to do that.
I'm sure it is.
Out front, this dumped over by Jablonski. Now sit from Jones in the middle. That was partially deflected by Jablonski up front, and Wolves will play it again. Have to track it down. Wow, that's a nice play by Cassie Jones. I don't know how she kept that in bounds. Back up front, Jones again to the outside. Tipped over by Circa, and that eventually goes off the hands of Hattie Stanberry. It's 10-7 Haywood. Front Jones to the middle. Pace let that fly. Good play by Peterson in the back row. Just tipped up front, and somebody's in the net. And they're going to call it on Jablonski, making 11-7 Haywood, and Cassie Jones will serve. Serve here from Jones, left back up front, and that goes off of Dancic, so 12-7 the lead for the Red Wolves.
A little distance between them and the Jaguars this second, second game.
Jones with the serve, that's an ace. It's now 13-7. And a serve there, played now up front, track down by Jablonski, hit into the net by Dancic. It's 15-7, and we're gonna get another timeout to Georgia Cumberland. Well, Georgia Cumberland took game one, trailing by 7 here in game two. We're back in a moment here on the NACA Television Network. The point goes to Cumberland out of the break. 14-8, the lead now for Haywood.
Moore coming in for Georgia Cumberland.
Serve here from Dancing, just out of bounds. That'll make it 15-8 Haywood. Also, if you're wondering what happens if this goes to three games, the third game would go only to 15. As that returned out of bounds for an ace, 16-8 delay. Jordan Pace will serve again. And that is into the net, making it 16-9.
All right, coming in for Georgia Cumberland, number 19, Shelby Hughes.
And Jess Rosales to serve here for Cumberland. Underhand serve, played by Stanberry. Dumped over there, returned on the slide by Rosales. That falls in, making it 16-10.
Cumberland going to try to make a run at it here. We've seen several games where teams made a good run right at the end.
Dumped across by Circa, now played back over by Jablonski. That goes out of bounds after being tipped, so it's 16-11 Haywood. Jess Rosales taking her time. Again, a short serve, and somehow it's saved by the Red Wolves. Good play by Jessica Circa. It's tipped across, and now Haywood will play it over. Dancic over to Hughes, who puts it across. Now put over by Moll. Dumped over by Jablonski. Played there by Circa. Dancic middle of the floor to Moore. That is blocked out of bounds. And it'll be 16-12.
Boy, if that had fallen inbounds, that would have been a great block.
Real close, too. It was only about a foot out of bounds or so. Serve from Rosales. She goes overhand this time. Tacked down by Jones. Now sent across by Moll. Circa to Moore, who just puts it over. It's tipped into the net. It's 16-13. So Cumberland starting to make a little bit of a move here.
Allie Moll for the Haywood team. Her older sister plays at Montreat, plays volleyball there. She's hoping to play college volleyball as well.
Montreat College. As that blocked up front by Moore. Nice play there. Cassie Jones trying to tip it across. 16-14. The lead now for Haywood. Montreat. Is that somewhere in the Carolinas?
Yes, North Carolina.
Okay, I thought so. Outside, this tipped across. Dancic tried to play it, and he make it 17-14. That was borderline going out, but back to serve for the Red Wolves is Jessica Circa. So Circa will try it again here. Sent across by Moore. Middle of the set, deep played there by Rosales. And sent up front and into the net by Jordan Jablonski. And now it's 18-14. Circa serve. Is an ace, and it's 19-14. Serve here from Circa. Turn back up. Now Jones over to Green, and Cumberland will play it here. Set near side to Moore. My good take in that back row by Stanberry. Moore tips it over. Now back and forth we go. Tip across there by Jones. Dump back over by Danzig. Danzig to set in the middle for Moore. And still alive. Into the net it goes. So 20-14 the lead for Hayward. Serve here from Circa. Play now up to Jones. That's sent across. Set to the near side. Moore. Good kill there from Brooklyn Moore. And it's 20-15 Haywood.
Number 20, Hayes Stanberry, coming back into the game for Haywood. Also for Georgia Cumberland, number 77, Mia Chin.
So Jordan Jablonski to serve. That is out of bounds. 21-15, the lead for Haywood.
Number 17, Shelby Llewellyn, coming in for Georgia Cumberland Lady Jaguars.
Now Hattie Stanberry, 5'6 sophomore, to serve for the Red Wolves. Out front. Hit from Moore, is partially deflected, now played back across. Over it comes to Hughes, who manages to get the hit to go down. 21-16 Haywood, and Brooklyn Moore to serve. Serve here, played by Stanberry, tipped into the net by Jones. It's 21-17 Haywood. Return now Danzig near side, punched across by Chin, and Allie Moll was in the net. So 21-18 the lead for Haywood. Here return in the net, and Ace makes it 21-19. And again, Cumberland making a little bit of a move, and a timeout to the Red Wolves. So back to a two-point game here in game number two. Take a break. We'll be back here just in a moment. Brooklyn Moore will serve here out of the timeout to the Red Wolves. 21-19, and there's an ace from Moore. It's 21-20. So Cumberland 1 point away from tying this after trailing by as many as 7 earlier. Moore serve, oh, just out of bounds on the far side. I mean, that was just out of bounds. 22-20. The lead for Haywood.
She had some heat on that one as well, man. It was smoking through the air.
Allie Moll's serve is an ace. And it's 23-20, the lead for Haywood. Well, a couple points away from the Red Wolves forcing a game three. Allie Moll, 5'6 sophomore, serves again into the net. 23-21. Only down for Haywood. And Shelby Hughes will serve for Georgia Cumberland. And And then it goes, so 24-21, and now game point for Haywood.
Coming into the game for Haywood, Jessica Cirka, and for Georgia Cumberland, Haley Peterson.
Serve here from Terry Green. Up front, Cirka to Rosales, who just puts it over. Pace, plays it across. And Danzig just bumped it over the top of the net. Kind of clipped the top as it went through. Rosales puts it over. Jones, bumped over by Pace. Moore sets it across, outside. And that'll do it for game two. 25-21 is the lead for Haywood. That'll force a game three. Game three will be to 15 points. So we'll take a break. We'll come back with the third deciding game here in just a couple minutes. Start of game number three in this best of three match. Served by Jordan Pace. Is returned by Haley Peterson. Out front, sent over by Cirka. Outside, that put across by Brooklyn Moore. Boy, good dig by Hattie Stanberry and then put into the net by Jessica Cirka. That's a 1-0 lead for Cumberland.
All right. We've talked about Clyde and their arboretum.
Yes, we did.
Got to tell you about an arborist coming to our home last year.
This ought to be interesting.
Oh, so, yes.
Sir from Rosales out front, tipped across, returned by Danzig. Now it's set back in the middle, put across there by Allie Mole. That's in, and we are tied at one.
So, coming into the game for Haywood Christian, number 15, Kerry Green, and for Georgia Cumberland, number 19, Shelby Hughes.
So Jessica Circa to serve for Haywood. Played by Rosales. Dancing to the outside. Hughes let that fly. Now tipped over by Cassie Jones. Jones back near side for Green. Played by Rosales. Moore. Good dig by Stanberry. And that's not going to clear the net. And a 2-1 lead for Cumberland.
Coming in for Haywood, Hayes Stanberry. Also for Georgia Cumberland, Mia Chan. So, you ever heard of a tree being waterlogged?
A waterlogged? Wait a minute. So, here's the serve. Give me one moment to think about that. Dumped over by Green. Now, Danzig out to Moore. Boy, another good dig by Hayes Stanberry in the back row. Out front, Danzig tips it over. And hit into the net and a 3-1 lead. So waterlogged, is the tree still, it's still alive, I take it?
Yes.
And it's waterlogged? How is this possible?
I will impart this wisdom. All right, now that we got a little bit of a break, we had heavy rains. So much. Coming to the game, by the way, for Georgia Cumberland, number 17. Shelby Llewellyn. It's going to kill you to give the answer.
A waterlogged tree, huh? That's an ace and we're tied at three.
Now just think, if Haywood had not played in this game, we would never did the research we did.
Come up with arboretum, and I never would have learned about you having an arborist at your house. And the serve here by Hattie Stanberry for the Red Wolves. Back across, Stanberry slides to save that again. Dumped over by Green, Danzig, and there's a carry, making it 4-3. Haywood.
So we had heavy rains where I live. Mm-hmm. I mean, like 6 weeks, and so much water was soaked up by the tree. It was waterlogged. And the leaves started falling off of it in the middle of the summer.
Really?
Yes.
That's very odd. That hit out of bounds by Cassie Jones. We're tied at four.
The leaves on the bottom half fell off. The top half stayed natural.
I don't think I've ever heard of that before. There's a serve by Brooklyn Moore. It's an ace, making it 5-4 Cumberland. So did this arborist act like this was a normal occurrence?
Yes.
Really? I have never heard of that. This return back into the net. As we're now tied at 5. Remember, this game goes to 15 here in game 3. Both teams have split games here. Cumberland won game 1. Haywood winning game 2. Over by Danzig. Now in the middle. Tipped across by Pace. And bumped over here by Hughes. And we're now having a 6-5 lead for Cumberland. You know, we were joking during the break. I said, why don't you just look up at Arborist in the phone book?
Yeah.
I never tried to do that. I mean, I guess it stands to reason they're in there. Yeah, I could see me telling my wife, hey, while I'm at work, call the arborist and schedule an appointment. That goes off at Danzig, and now we're tied at 6.
Coming in for Georgia Cumberland is number 10, Haley Peterson, and for Haywood Christian, number 5, Jessica Circa.
Serve here from Kerry Green. Yeah, played by Danzig. Bumped over from Rosales. Played back in the middle. Rosales puts it across. played over that hit out of bounds by Jessica Circa, and it's 7-6 Cumberland.
Number 3, Sadie Dixon coming in for Cumberland, as well as number 4, Jordan Jablonski.
Sadie Dixon to serve here. Play now up front by Pace. And this will go off the hands of Haley Peterson in that back row. We're now tied at 7. Well, I guess we couldn't get any closer than what we've had this match. These two teams very evenly matched. Almost too evenly matched. And then neither team really gets a big advantage. Danzig just bumps it over. Near side Circa. Now back to Moore, who bumps it across. Out front, put over by Pace. Now Moore just tips it over, and nice play from Brooklyn, and 8-7 the lead for Cumberland.
Next game coming up after this one is Hickory versus Jellies.
Jelly. Makes me hungry. And some toast. I guess these Cheez-Its will have to do. We're tied at 8. And Jordan Pace set to serve for Haywood Christian. Played near side. Rosales. Back over to Dixon, who puts it across. Dumped over by Jones. Back middle of the floor. Sent over there by Jablonski. Danzig to the outside. Moore. Back to your side. And there's a kill for Jessica Circa. And a 9-8 lead for Haywood. Remember, this game only goes to 15. Not that far away. Serve from Pace. And back up front, dumped over by Danzig, out of bounds. And it's 10-8. And timeout to Cumberland. 10-8 the lead for Haywood. Back here in just a moment for more Game 3. Serve out of the timeout by Jordan Pace is an ace. Now 11-8 the lead for Haywood. Serve from Pace played by Brooklyn Moore on this line. Now that's sent across by Hattie Stanberry. Moore tips it over. Returned by Jones. Go back to Moore again. Now near side. Sent over by Circa. Tipped across up front, and we have an illegal hit on Jordan Jablonski, and it's 12-8 Haywood. Serve from Pace. And now up front, tipped across, and I believe Jablonski is in the net, and it's 13-8 Haywood. Pace with the serve. Tracked down now by Dixon, and that will go out of bounds 14-8 the lead for Haywood, and this is match point. So Haywood lost game one, they win game two, and they're on the verge of winning game three. Pace with the serve, tracked down by Moore, bumped over by Dixon. Now out front, Danzig lets it fly, Stanbury plays it. Up front, bumped over there by Jones. Sent over by Jablonski. Back in the middle, Jones dumps that back across. And that'll do it. 15-8 the final in game three. Haywood comes back to win it. Two out of three games by taking games two and three. Haywood Christian winning it 15-8 here in the third. Up next, we'll take a little detour over into Division I in that second chance bracket. We'll do that in just a little bit. You've been watching the NACA National Championship Tournament.